Hi everyone, welcome to this video tutorial on how to create and configure Syncfusion React Calendar using the create react app command. I'm going to show you how to add the calendar component to an app using the Syncfusion EJ2 React Calendars package. Then I will show you how to configure a few of its basic features like setting specific date range values, multi-date selection, and navigation between different calendar views such as a month, year, and decade. Let me show you the application creation process. First, I create my app using the Create React App toolchain. I use VS Code as the editor and show the output in Chrome browser. In VS Code, I need to install the command npm install create react app. As I have already installed this toolchain, I will skip this step here. Then I create a new application using the command create react app and provide the app name my react app. I set the script version to template TypeScript. I navigate to the desired location and run the sample using the command npm start. Now I can edit the app.tsx page to show the calendar here. Next, I remove the default code snippets from the app.tsx file and styles from the app.css file. Then I install the Syncfusion calendar package using the command npm install Syncfusion EJ2 React Calendars. After the package is installed, I import the material theme styles to the app.css file to apply styles to the calendar component. To start using the calendar component, I import it from the EJ2 React Calendars package and then include the calendar component tag. Now I run my application. As you can see, the output displays the calendar component with current date highlighted. You can also navigate between the calendar dates, months, and years. Next, I'll show you how to select a specific date value on the calendar so that the calendar highlights the date on initial load. Dates can be specified using the value property. I define a variable date value of date type and assign any date value to it. I then assign this variable to the value property of the calendar. As you can see, the specified date value is selected on the calendar. Now let me show you how to restrict the date value selection within a specified range by defining the min and max properties. First, I declare a variable start date of the date type and set any date value. Similarly, I define another variable and set it as the end date value. Next, I assign these values to the corresponding min and max properties. Check now. I cannot select the date values that lie beyond the specified min and max date range. By default, I can perform single date selection in calendar. To select multiple dates in a calendar, I add isMultiSelection property and set its value to true. Check now, I can select multiple date values in the calendar. Finally, I will show you how to change and navigate between different views of the calendar. There are three types of calendar views: month, year, and decade. So far, I have been working with the default month view. To change the view to decade, I'll add the start property and set its value to decade. Now, the calendar displays the years in a decade. When I click a specific year in the calendar, it shows the list of months in a year, and on clicking the month again, it shows the days of the selected month. This is the drill down action of calendar view navigation from decade to month view. Now I will show you how to control the drill up action of calendar view navigation using the depth property. Using start and depth properties together, I can limit the drill down and drill up actions of the calendar while navigating through the views. So let me include the depth property and set its value to year. Note that the depth value should always be lesser than the start value. As you can see, when I select any year from the calendar, it shows months in a year, and on clicking any month, it does not show the days of that month. This shows how easily you can define the features of React Calendar using its simple built-in APIs. Let me summarize what we have seen so far. You have learned how to create a React app using the Create React App command and add a Syncfusion React Calendar component to it. I explained how to configure the component with its features like setting a specific date value and date range to it. Finally, I showed you how to select multi-dates in the calendar component and explain the month, year, and decade views. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see if you are eligible for our community license, which will get you a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.